I'm really excited to show you what I have on the desk here today. As a maker, I've always been interested in seeing how the workflows would change as new developments come along. And as a child, I grew up in a time where there were spaceships and laser swords, and I was always interested in being able to use lasers to create the things that I was inspired to make. So today, I'm lucky enough to play with a Emblaser 2 from Darkly Labs, and I'm gonna show you why this machine gets me extremely excited. Not the way you think, but this machine here can actually change the way you make. So let me introduce you to the Emblaser 2 from Darkly Labs. This machine is incredible. In the sense of laser cutting, this takes it all to a completely new level. Let me explain to you why this is different from traditional laser cutters. If I had put a laser cutter in my workspace here, I'd have to do a few things. I'd have to organize a water-cooled system to keep the laser tube cooled, and I'd also need an extraction vent in the actual workspace here to be able to make sure that whatever I'm cutting, I'm venting safely away. Well, this machine is actually designed with a venting system in place. There's a tube that comes out the back and it self-vents, and I can actually put this out through any window in my house or in the workspace. I can open up the door and put the vent outside. This machine actually has 4-point sensors in the top lid to make sure that if anyone touches it, immediately turns power off from the laser. The other part that I really like about it is that idea that if anything becomes alight within the machine immediately turns itself off and sets an alarm out so that anyone around the machine can come straight and put the fire out. That's something that a lot of smaller laser cutters, especially the hobby cutters from China, are missing out on. I've actually just recently had a friend who was working on a small Chinese laser cutter. He went off to the other side of the workshop, the machine caught a light, and he actually melted parts in the machine. That machine is now down. Thank goodness it didn't take out the whole house. So this machine is extremely safe when it comes to being able to put it into a home environment, a home workshop, a makerspace, or even a school. The other thing that I really like about this machine, I mean, I really like this, is that it works straight out of the box. It literally took me maybe 5 to 10 minutes to set up a file to cut on my computer, and I was able to actually use this machine and get a result straight away. That is incredible. Now, I haven't had that experience with any other machines, especially laser cutters, let alone 3D printers and CNC machines. This machine literally comes ready out of the box. And that's pretty amazing to see. It just means that you can actually go and literally open the box, put it in a classroom, put it in your workshop, and actually be able to go get some stuff created very, very quickly. You don't need, as I mentioned before, you don't need any secondary equipment. You don't need vents. You don't need water cooling systems. And again, that makes this machine very attractive to the maker or to the teaching institution, which is very, very cool. The other thing that I really like about it is that this machine has quite a large work area. It's 500 by 300. I've actually got a piece of MDF here that I was cutting out before, but you can see this area fits nicely inside and you're able to work with it straight away. It also connects with USB or through Wi-Fi, and that's something else that I really enjoy. I don't have to run cables to a laptop that's on the other side of my workspace or in my classroom. I can actually, as a teacher, be able to load up a file, send it to the laser cutter, have the students take a look at what's going on, and I can also hook up my computer to a projector and show them what's going on. The other part about it, when it comes to actually sharing what's going on, is that this machine has a built-in camera. So I can use that to actually line up my cuts on material that's in there, or do a live update with my students or myself when I'm on the other side of a workspace. In fact, if your workspace isn't home, you could potentially be on the other side of the house, hooked up with Wi-Fi, and be able to actually see what's going on. And again, those are abilities that I haven't seen in out-of-the-box machines to this point. The list of things that you can cut on this machine right now are cotton, felt, leather, cardboard, acrylic plastic, which is what laser cutters are known to use all the time, propylene, styrene, balsa, oak, MDF, cork, and even rubber. Now, what's really interesting with this machine as well is that you can actually engrave on anodized aluminium and even slate. So as a first look, I'm really impressed with the hardware here. If you actually open up and take a closer look at this machine, you can actually see it runs very similar to a 3D printer in the sense that it's using different vectors in the actual cutting itself. That part of it I find really, really interesting because you're building on a 20-year background of technology, servo motors, and controllers. So I'm really impressed with the hardware that goes into the Emblaze 2 from Darkly Labs. I really enjoy it. But you know what? My experience has been that if the software side of things doesn't match that workflow to actually get the results you want, all the hardware in the world is great. But if you can't make it do what you need it to do when you need it to do it, sometimes I wonder what the point is. But the good part about this is the guys down at Darkly Labs has partnered up with a company that creates a piece of software called Lightburn. And Lightburn runs the laser cutter. And Lightburn's actually been adopted by a lot of hobbyist laser cutter aficionados because it is so intuitive to get the results you want. I really like Lightburn. It actually answers a lot of the questions that I've had when I've used laser cutters previously. In my case, it's always been using CNC software and trying to push and pull it to get a result out of a laser cutter. This software is designed specifically for laser cutters, and it will accept any format of image that you need, whether it's a JPEG, a PNG, an Illustrator file, maybe something out of InkSpace. It accepts all of that. And the other thing that I really love about this piece of software is that it has a scan algorithm that is the easiest thing I've ever used in my life. You can literally bring in an image, scan it, turn it into a vector, and then place it onto whatever it is that you want to mark or cut in the laser cutter. The other thing that's really beautiful about this is that in tangent with the actual camera, you can draw and design your own design, put it into the laser cutter, scan it within Lightburn, and then place it on whatever it is that you want to mark. So you can actually do this in a class with young children where they can actually draw the designs and you can actually be able to transfer that design onto a finished product. That to me is incredibly powerful. Just the fact that you've got the camera to line up your designs on some material is powerful in itself, but to be able to merge that in within Lightburn, I gotta be honest with you, I was cutting things out literally within 10 minutes of setting up. That blew my mind. If it's easy enough for me to do it, it's easy enough for students to do it, that's incredible because once they learn that pathway, that CNC pathway, they'll be able to use software like this to set up any sort of job, even if you're cutting 10 mil perspex, which unfortunately this machine is not empowered to do. But that's great. If that's the only negative, well, mate, I'm gonna do all my prototyping on this and then take it to a company that can cut through that sort of material 24 hours a day. Lightburn also allows you to work on any different format that you want. You can work within Windows, you can work within a Mac. If you've got a PC tablet, you will also be able to work within this software directly to the laser cutter. So again, you've got USB or you've got Wi-Fi. Take your computer, go work on something else while the machine is cutting on the other side of your workshop. That gives you incredible flexibility. I really love this machine. I gotta be honest with you. In the last day that I've played with it, I've already come up with about 10 projects that I wanna do in the workshop and around the home. These are things that I've always wanted to do, but I just didn't have the time to take it to the bandsaw and cut things out. But if I can get the laser cutter to actually do the hard work for me while I'm doing something else, or maybe even working on, I can set up one project while I'm working on the other, that's a time factor saving for me that makes investing in a machine like this worthwhile. And you know what else? I really love this, so you know what? I was gonna explain it to you, but I think I'll just show you. This machine is so light, I can literally carry it to my car and take it to anywhere I want to go. So next time I go to a school and I want to do a laser cutting project, I've got the laser cutter literally in my hand. That's it for me right now. I'm incredibly impressed with the Emblaze 2. I want to show you guys what I can do with this. So keep your eye out for other projects. I've got some really exciting stuff coming up. I want to really thank the guys from Darkly Labs for sharing this machine with me. One of the things that I absolutely love about it is the fact that it is Australian made. It's been designed in Melbourne, and it's just so nice to touch base with a company that's keeping makers and education in mind, and it's not coming from the US or overseas. So you know what? I'm gonna head off to a class right now. I'm gonna catch you guys later, and let's see what we can do with our Emblaze 2s. See ya.